Greetings, Eric Baker. Thanks for coming back, checking out my channel. I like reading studies. And here's a really cool one. I'll show you. We're going to talk about this one. As you know, there's been a big increase globally in autoimmune disease, inflammatory disease, heart disease, many different illnesses. There's been a big increase in them, you know. And we call these idiopathic. Well, what the hell does idiopathic mean? Well, when you learn medical jargon, you know, you hear these sort of terms, idiopathic. It doesn't mean that you're a pathetic idiot. What it means is there's no known cause. We don't know. You know, the pathos is the Latin, I think, the Latin for disease. So there's no known cause really for a lot of these. Well, no scientific cause, but there's always a cause. It just hasn't really been found. To me, it's clear, you know. When you see studies like this, it's pretty obvious. This is the first study that actually shows there's a relationship between ultraviolet light and an improvement in the gut microbiota. This is really exciting stuff. I just really like this sort of stuff. This really correlates with, you know, a lot of the information that I've been presenting now for so long. Science is finally validating that lifestyle, especially getting out in the sun, you know, we'll talk about specific times in a minute, but getting out in the sun really improves your health. But now science is showing that getting out in the sun actually improves your gut microbiota. Funny that. Well, I tell you, I love going out in the sun, but I'm no fool. I wouldn't go out in the middle of the day on a hot summer's day. You know, I do wear a hat and take protection, but I'm quite lucky with my skin, and some people are, I suppose. You know, I've spent many hours in the sun. So if you look at the sun, and especially the ultraviolet spectrum, UVA and UVB, the ultraviolet A is actually the really damaging one, you know. That's the one that really peppers the earth. 95% of the ultraviolet that comes from the sun is UVA. It's a very powerful light source. It penetrates deep into the skin. It can create a lot of harm and damage for some people. I look at people like my mum and myself. I spent many hours in the sun as a child, and I sort of got away with it, but other people don't. You know, they get cancers and melanomas, and especially people like my partner Tracy with very fair skin, they get fried, so they've got to watch out. UVB, you know, it's a different band, a narrow band, particularly the narrow band of the UVB has a really good effect on the body. This is what we're looking for to increase the vitamin D, 25-hydroxy vitamin D gets a good boost up by this. Now, the study is very interesting because what it showed, they got a group, they got healthy cohorts. So here they got two groups of females. One was given vitamin D leading up to winter time, and the other one was not given vitamin D. The one that was not given vitamin D, in fact, both groups had this, were exposed to ultraviolet B 3 or 4 times per week. They're exposed. And of course, vitamin D levels were assessed throughout. What they discovered after only a mere week or two, that there was a 7.3% increase actually in the vitamin D in the bloodstream of the people who were exposed to this. Haha, well, we already knew that. We know that ultraviolet B increases vitamin D. But the crazy thing is they also found an improvement in the gut microbiota. They found changes. They found bugs increasing. Certain bacteria were coming up and really responding. So whether that's a relationship with the vitamin D or a separate issue remains to be seen. But the point I'm making here is when you go out in the sun, you're actually improving your gut microbiota. And science is finally validating that. Skin exposure modulates the human intestinal microbiome. So all those people trapped in offices all day that rarely go out in the sun, you need to get out in the sun. I've always maintained this. The sun should not be shunned. It's healthy. But the best time to go in the sun, of course, you know, is usually before 10 a.m. or 11, and then again late afternoon. You don't go in the sun all in the middle of the day lying in a bikini and then wondering why you look like a lobster, okay? The UVB is what makes the skin red and burns it. So common sense, you know, you wear light clothing and stuff like that and you protect your skin. I am not a fan of that stuff that you slap all over, those chemicals you slap all over your body. I prefer people use things like coconut oil, and particularly to stay out of the hottest part of the day and also to wear some more protective clothing. So there you have it. It makes sense to get out in the sun, okay? Now I'm getting out in the sun soon because you've got springtime here and of course I'm short sleeves, so it's warming up. We're gonna get probably in the 90s, even maybe, who knows, mid 90s next week. It's gonna be hot, hot, hot. Thanks for tuning in. Appreciate the viewers, I always do. More videos to come. We've got some really good questions here that have been asked, and I'll be replying to these very shortly. Click on the link below. There's probably something for you free to take home. Thanks very much.